What to do, 2K fans? This your boy, Drew King the Boss, and I'm back at it again with another video. Now, I've noticed that a lot of people have been watching my videos for NBA 2K League information. I told y'all that throughout the entire year, I'm going to follow the league, regardless of whether I'm competing or whether I'm participating. It doesn't matter. I want to keep you all involved as much as possible because this is something I want to see succeed. I don't think I can reiterate that enough, that this is something I want to see do well. Now, and I've been getting in some practice with my squad. I got a few games that I got to finish editing so y'all can see exactly, you know, what we're doing, what we've been working on. I upload these videos also for them so that way they can see what we need to work on in transition defense and work on in half-court defense, half-court offense, working on offensive sets. We've had heated discussions left and right about teams not having offensive sets, and I said I really want that to be the thing that kind of sets us apart as individuals and as a team. If you're a person who can run an offensive set with your team in this digital environment, then you're going to be someone that a league team is going to look at more closely, because they want to see not only can this person run offensive sets on this game, but at the same time they have an IQ for knowing when to rotate, when to shift, this, that, and the other. So I mean, you're going to see a lot of them. We're going to see mistakes we made, you're going to see some of the great things we've done, and I'm going to kind of just talk to y'all about the league and go over some things that people are kind of a little worried about. Now, as far as all those who think that the league's participants have already been decided and chosen, that's not necessarily the case. When it boils down to it, there are people who have had such a social media presence or public presence in this game, competing in several tournaments over the past few years and playing as hard as they do, gaining a following the way that they do, that of course that they're the guys who you expect that they're going to be in this league, they're going to participate. Now, what you got to realize is look at some of the other YouTubers that you probably asked questions to and said, hey, are you going to compete? Are you going to play in the league? Some of them have said, nah, because, you know, I got my social media thing I'm doing. I got my YouTube thing I'm doing. I got my Twitch thing I'm doing, and it's my biggest revenue stream. So when it boils down to it, I don't see myself competing, because though the league said that you'll still be able to do your streams and record other games and record your gameplay when you're playing on your own time, they, you know, a lot of cats say that they kind of like being able to set their own schedule and do their own thing, and they don't want the league then to kind of get in the way of that. So when it boils down to it, don't let that take that knowledge, and don't let the fact that someone might have a bigger social media clout disappoint you or let you down thinking that you can't compete, because at the end of the day, you want it to boil down to skill. And if it doesn't boil down to skill, then, you know, we'll kind of watch the league fold before it really gets started. And they don't want to see that happen, because it's another money-making stream that they can set themselves up with. So another thing I kind of wanted to go over is that at the end of the day, when it comes down to some tips that I can give you on playing good basketball, I said in the last few videos that play team pro-am. Now, I've seen people say on Twitter that they're going to play walk-on pro-am to kind of get the feel of playing with different kinds of people. And I can tell you that from personal experience, that's really not necessarily a good thing. And the reason why I say that is because here's a plus side of playing walk-on pro-am. When it comes down to who I'm going to play with on the team, this is my team I created. I got my set of people that I prefer playing with, my boys. I never mind trying somebody new out, because you never know that person you might try out might be a missing piece. There's a guy I play with named Bans. He was a great addition to the team. He has a center that is a pure rim protector, and he plays his position. He knows his role, and we do everything we can to get him more involved in the offense. I've done footage with him, so if you've seen any of my last videos, you might have seen him play alongside me. He can get some buckets, but at the same time, his number one thing is being able to defend the paint and play heavy at the rim, to try to keep the congestion inside controlled by him. Now, some more tips I can give you when it comes down to playing. So let's say you decided you're going to play team pro-am during the month of January. That's what you're going to use to get your... The reason why you want to do that is because first and foremost is that you want them to see how well you can play as a part of a team. You want them to know how you can communicate with your team. One of the biggest things that my team and I go over is whether we're communicating or not, and does that lead to a win? Does that lead to an L? Now, there are times where we don't communicate our best and we still get a win. And we look at those times and say we kind of snuck away with that one. We kind of stole that victory and things like that. And the reason being is because you need to be able to communicate with your team at all times. You never know who's seeing what on the floor. I'm a guy who likes to try and see what kind of defense we're running up against. We space the floor as much as possible so that way we can see where the defense is going to line up. Are they chasing their man? Are they playing tight, a denied defense? Are they cutting off the passing lanes for each offensive player? And everything like that. And then when we're on, it allows us to decide what kind of sets we can run on offense, what kind of plays we can run on offense. Can we set screens? We set screens left and right, but we don't set as many screens on ball as we do off ball. So like, you'll see one of us set a screen off ball off on a person that doesn't have the ball in their hand to get them open, because maybe they have the weak man, they have the misman advantage and everything like that, that's checking them. And you're supposed to take advantage of those. So another thing I kind of want to go over, we're going to dive more back into tips that you can do in game. Now, social media setups and just kind of like getting your content out there. If you want them to see you, you need to, like I said, you need to be using that hashtag 2KDraftMe. So that way, if you're uploading videos or you're streaming, they know to look for that hashtag, and most of them are going to see your footage and things like that. I've used it on one of my streams, my first stream that I've run officially on the channel. I've run streams in the past, kind of just testing out my hardware and everything like that, and what where lags at, what I need to pick up on. But let's dive back into what really matters now. When it comes down to using the 2K DraftMe, make sure that you know that this is not some stream that I'm just kind of like, this is for the giggles. It's just literally having way too much fun and kind of being a little more aggressive. Keep your stuff as clean as you possibly can. I can't reiterate that enough. Keep it as clean as possible. And for those of y'all who don't have like a computer set up to run streams, that gives you limitations, but it doesn't keep you out of the running. The Xbox and PlayStation 4, these are the platforms, the Xbox One and the PlayStation 4, these are the platforms that they're gonna be counting for your 50 wins. And both of these platforms have the ability to stream directly from the platform, directly from the system itself. So you want to kind of get yourself involved in that and just like literally have some fun with it. Like, be able to sit up here and say, kick back, relax. I know the one thing about it is that if I'm playing a game in an instance where I'm not playing to show my dominance and this, that, and the other, I'm not playing to get all the stats, I'm just playing to be a team player, have some fun, and at the same time get a win, then I'm gonna play my best. I was playing earlier today. Now, this footage is from a couple days ago, but I was playing earlier today, and the one thing about it was I was playing walk-on, and the teams we was playing against, hey, look at that turnover. See what I'm saying? Bad ball movement for me. Now, the team we were playing against, they had better basketball knowledge, but not by much. The team I was playing with, they didn't have the best basketball knowledge, but you know, at the end of the day, it's about most people out there just trying to get buckets. Some people are not out there to compete or be competitive. They're out there to kind of get their man up as quick as possible and do the things that they can do that's going to get them the most experience points to get their person up. So when I play this game, I play this game to have fun. I'm building new builds every day just because I want to keep the game fun for me. But I told y'all that I'm going to follow the league. I'm going to keep myself involved in it as much as possible just because I want to see it succeed. So now let's get back to playing good team basketball. Now, throughout this game, you probably saw some bad rotations, some bad pickups, some bad mismatches that we didn't take advantage of. That play right there was a good play that we kind of got lucky with. And it was because you saw a lot of us jumping. We had our hands up in the air, but we let them get us off our feet way too many times. We got lucky to get the blocks. Now, when it comes down to setting good screens and catching men running to the basket, cutting to the basket, that's what it's going to boil down to. Tyson Chandler is a basketball player who is most notably known for all of those stats that don't show up on the stat sheet. You know, now you've probably heard it say being said a couple times in 2K if you played a game against him or played a game with him, that he gets all the stats that don't really show up. He's the one who sets the screen that gets the man open. He's the one who runs a pick and roll game better than most. I won't say better than most, but you know, he sets himself up to not be the one who's getting the points, but getting himself involved in the offense, getting himself involved in the defense. It's about positioning. It's about making a great pass, making a great plays. So, you know, like I said, this is just some more information just to let y'all know, like, hey, look, I'm out here competing like the rest of y'all. I'm out here competing like the rest of them. Don't have a big viewer count. Don't have a big subscription count. But at the end of the day, if you have a way to share your footage on social media, do it, man. Because, like, at the end of the day, I don't want to just see the guys you expect to play. I want to see the guys who you don't see competing in tournaments or you didn't see make it past qualifiers getting a chance to kind of show what they can do in this league and be a part of a team. Because I've seen teams that we played against, teams where we've had one or two people on the team we played against that was actually killing us. And like, they were hurting us bad because they were able to get buckets, and the team that we were playing against knew that these were the two that could get the buckets, so they set them up in a position to score. And sometimes you don't really notice that. So you got the guys who are getting the buckets, they're the ones who people think, oh yeah, they're going to be the ones that get drafted. But you look at the guys who were setting them up to get those buckets, and you say, you would love to see them on a team. You would love to see them competing, because they can set their team up to get good buckets. They can set their team up to get good play. So, like I said, I'm looking forward to seeing, because I'm going to be following the hashtag 2KDraftMe just to see what kind of footage comes from the community itself. I want to see this do successful. I know I kind of just did a lot of rambling at times, but I'm hoping that as you all kind of just look at the footage, see the smart pass we made, see the good plays we made, and then also be able to also see where we made our mistakes. You see any mistakes that you think we made, something we need to work on, and let me know down in the comments below. You know, if you like the video, make sure you share it with somebody else so that way they can like the video, so that way I can show up a little more in the search results. So that we can get this following going, we can get a little more clout going on the YouTube space. I've been enjoying what I've been doing over the past several months. I'm glad to see that the footage I've been putting together, the clips I've been putting together for people on YouTube, has been helping the 2K community. I know a lot of people just got 2K for Christmas. I'm hoping you all are enjoying it. I'm hoping that it's better than it was when it came out for us. When it came out for us, there was a lot of ups and downs, mostly downs. I want to see what's going to go down. Look at that shot. See, I got to be more consistent with shots like that. I'm looking forward to seeing, you know, where we go from here when it comes down to 2K, and where the 2K league goes. You know, I hope you all like the video. Make sure you share it with someone else so that way they can like the video. Subscribe if you guys are new. I'm going to catch you guys on the next one. I'm out. Peace. All right, y'all, for y'all who made it this far, 2018 is going to be a big year. I watched my channel grow a little bit and get a few subscribers. And so just to let y'all know, I'm working on GTA Online footage. And at the same time, I'm going to continue with NBA 2K18. Also, there's a new game going to be coming out, I think, in February called Identity for PC. That'll be the first PC game footage that I ever record. I want to speak with the devs to see, to make sure that it's okay that I record footage of that game when it comes out. I'll see you guys in 2018. Peace.